It's a chilly evening in the Pacific Northwest with two teams slated to face off and shake off a cold start to conference play as the Portland Pilots host the San Diego Toreros. Welcome inside the Child Center. I'm Brian Slyke, joined by former Gonzaga Bulldog Jennifer Mountain, and we'll have your call tonight. Portland and San Diego, they find themselves in the bottom half of the WCC. However, both have some electric pieces and seem destined to have a turnaround at some point. So what are you expecting between these two tonight, Jennifer?
Big weekend for both squads. USD coming in 2-4 in conference play. They're in the process of building a program. They're getting better, playing really, really well at times. They have some dynamic guards who really want to run and push the pace, and looking to climb the ladder with a win against the Pilots today. And a big weekend for this Portland squad. You know, they have the toughest three road trips behind them. They're getting healthier by the minute. We've seen glimpses of greatness, high expectations on this squad, and a great chance to take care of business at home.
You talked about those dynamic guards. They have a few that can really pour it on for the Toreros, but tonight we focus on the guard from Dallas, and that's Jace Townsend.
Yeah, he's the leading scorer for this San Diego squad. Had 25 the other night against Pepperdine. He can really create, gets to the rim and finish, can shoot the three, and is great from the free throw line. He must have a great offensive night for the Toreros on the road.
San Diego has had luck against Portland in the past. How do they get the win tonight inside the Child Center?
First thing, they need to limit their turnovers. Offensive flow, they really like to push the pace, like I said, but they've got to be efficient. Second chance points out of rebounding will be a huge factor tonight, and then they've got to guard the three-point line. USD is last in three-point field goal defense in the conference, and Portland can really shoot it.
One of the better players for Portland, who's been the hottest player on the court as of late, is Christian Schoen.
Yeah, back-to-back double-doubles against San Fran and Gonzaga. He can score inside out, is explosive to the rim, has the ability to shoot that three from deep. Create, and he is a dynamic rebounder, and that is going to be the biggest job for him tonight. He's got to be the man on the boards for them to have a win.
Portland needs this win not only for tonight, but this week and for the rest of their season. What do they need to do to get that win?
First off, they have to defend the ball one-on-one, keep it in front, and then they have to handle the pressure and limit their turnovers. No live ball turnovers. Execution on the offensive end, they need to shoot it well from the three, and then that pace of play, they need to play their style because this could be a track meet.
Yeah, these two teams are going to go up and down the court, so you don't want to move from that seat. We've got your West Coast Conference action between San Diego and Portland with lineups and tip coming up next. Welcome back onto the campus of the University of Portland for our action between San Diego and Portland. Brian Slyke and Jennifer Mountain with your call. We've got starting lineups now. We're just a few moments away from the tip and the start from this one. Let's get you those starters for San Diego on the court. I should say it's going to be Jace Townsend, Wayne McKinney III, Marcellus Erlington, Sigu Sisoho-Jawara, and Eric Williams Jr. But Erlington is a name we should keep an eye on as well.
Absolutely, a 6'7" senior. Second leading scorer on the squad. He has had good games against the Pilots in the past. He's got to have another one tonight.
And a bit of a shakeup here for the Pilots. A name we're used to seeing, it's Tyler Roberts and Moses Wood. Christian Schoen, those three are staples in the starting lineup. But Chica and Duca getting the start. And then our man Juan Sebastian Gorosito. Juanzi getting the start tonight.
Yeah, big start for the freshman. And I'm telling you, if you haven't seen this guy play, he's very dynamic, has a lot of emotion, and really can shoot the ball, especially deep from the three. And he's going to be a great addition, have a great career, but nice to see him get a start, add a little spark for this Portland squad.
Opening tip is won by the Pilots as Anduka comes down with it. And you should expect these two to go up and down the court tonight. Lots of movement as Wood hit the floor, and that should be a travel. And there it is, turnover.
Well, we talked about this in the open. Turnovers are going to be crucial. A little slip there by Wood. Got himself a little bit caught and kind of stood up with that basketball. He's got to stay down on it and make a pass from the floor.
Eric Williams Jr., the transfer from Oregon, brought the ball up the court for San Diego. He has been electric for the Toreros at 1 point, scoring 43 points in a single game. As he puts up the three right here, tipped by Robertson, no good.
Well, this is going to be a really fast game. I mean, you're going to see a lot of on balls, a lot of, you know, dribble handoffs, backdoor cuts, and a lot of three balls by both squads.
There's the first one put up by the Pilots. It's short, front iron, rebound by Williams.
Well, when Portland can shoot well from the three-point line, really good things can happen. And we talked about San Diego being last in the conference in three-point field goal defense. That will be a huge factor tonight.
And with guys like Schoen and Wood who don't need a whole bunch of space and put up good shots, something to keep an eye on. Wood skies for that rebound.
Good help side defense by Schoen coming over, making that a contested shot.
There's a three put up. Gorosito knocks it down.
Well, I'll tell you, if he gets going, watch out, because this kid can really shoot it from deep.
He's averaging just under 7 points per game this season, shooting 40.5% from behind the arc. Step back, jumper. Just rims off.
Nice looking shot right there. It's a hard one to defend. That step back is hard to defend.
Another three put up by Portland, and they knock it down. 6 points now. Two triples, one from Wood, one from Gorosito.
Well, you love to see the rhythm coming off that, just a quick down screen and transition. And like we talked about, Portland really can shoot the basketball, and they're getting healthier and healthier. A lot of things can happen for this squad.
Erlington finds back iron there. It'll be one and done for the Toreros. Portland has not put up a shot inside the three-point arc yet.
Well, with a little smaller lineup, there's a nice little move right there.
Erlington, tough take to the basket. He gets fouled ahead of the line for a three-point play. And that foul is going to be on Chica and Duca, his first, team's first.
Well, you see the nice little spin move, good body control by Erlington, and a great finish.
We saw the lineup shake up for Portland with Nduka and Gorosito in the lineup. You know, Nduka had some good games against San Diego last year. They knew that he could match up well against Erlington. And early on, we're sort of seeing that physicality between those two.
Well, and they need some production inside a little bit, just banging people around, especially defensively and rebounding. So, you know, that's kind of in Chica's bread and butter, is mixing it up, as we all know. Forced there by Wood, trying to enter from the wing spot. Nice pass.
Beautiful lead pass, and Eric Williams beats Schoen to the rim.
McKinney with a great pass.
Threaded that needle between the defenders. Schoen working for position on the block against Williams. Flattens the ball and still puts it in.
Well, great catch and great balance to not travel on that. Went down, actually touched the floor. I think they might have missed that one, but nonetheless. And you like to see, you know, everybody really getting involved offensively so far in this game.
McKinney's pass to Irwington near the baseline.
Yeah, you can see those two banging on the block.
And you can't leave that man wide open. Williams knocks down the triple.
Just smooth lefty, I love it.
Grad student from Port Huron, Michigan. At his third home now, transfer from Duquesne and Oregon. Wood, off balance shot, no good. He gets fouled ahead of the line for two.
Boy, I like what Portland did there. They denied up top on that reversal, and Wansey came to that high post, hit him in that free throw line, and a nice high-low option for Wood with free throws.
Irwington picked up the foul. That'll be his first, team's first. Now, Wood was out for a couple of weeks, and you really felt that pain for the Pilots as they struggled in those early conference games. But he's a big part of their success, averaging just a hair under 14 points per game. As he makes the free throw there. He's second on the team in scoring, and he's the biggest three-point threat that they have at times.
Well, I mean, having him back in the lineup obviously gives you multiple things. You got a defender, a rebounder, scorer. Yeah. I mean, he scores in all levels. And the thing about it, I mean, this Portland squad's been hit by injuries. It's like once we get one person back, you know, somebody else goes out. So, you know, it's nice to see people getting healthy. I think we may have a chance to see Meadows here tonight at some point. But that's going to make a big difference moving forward.
Looking at him right now, looks like he's got a heat pad on his thigh. Townsend gives the ball up to Jawara.
Good defense.
Back to Townsend, the three. Robertson closing out, it doesn't matter.
Well, Townsend's got a deep range. You got to get a hand up. You know, we talk about it, you got to be smart and play the drive with him.
Off balance shot. Missed time the jump, and it'll be a rebound for San Diego. The Toreros have hit their last four shots from the field, and they trail by one.
Well, we talked about the pace. These guys want to go quick.
Irwington backing down Robertson. Oh. And he'll get the bucket. He has a chance for a second three-point play.
Well, he loves that spin back. A little fadeaway. That's a tough shot to guard. And, you know, Portland, you can't foul on that shot. You make that contested, make him make a tough one over you.
So San Diego with a chance to add on to their lead. It's 11-10. 13-10. We'll be right back on WCC Network. Jonte Leggins, the second-year head coach for the Portland Pilots, just surpassed that 100 career win mark a few games back, but he has done some terrific things in a short amount of time here on the Bluff, Jennifer.
He has changed the culture. I mean, you walk in this building, you can feel the difference, the type of guys that are on the floor, the chemistry. It's just going to continue to get better as time goes on here, getting his guys in, and he's just done a terrific job.
Irwington making the free throw and completing his second three-point play of the night so far. He's got 6 points, and San Diego, they're on a 6-0 run over the last 40 seconds, and they started out 0-for-4, and then have made their last five shots as the Pilots turn it over for the third time.
Well, there's that force inside right there. You'd love to see ball movement before that goes inside, even if Robertson right there had a little bit of position down low. San Diego doing a nice job just kind of pulling the chair from him and going the other way with the turnover, second turnover of the game. Excuse me, third turnover of the game.
See if San Diego can capitalize. Jawara over to Erlington. There's that battle in Duca. On his back, Erlington picks up his dribble, kicks it out to Jawara. The three again falls for San Diego.
Well, you saw Scholin kind of dig down a little bit, leaving him at the three-point line. You just cannot leave shooters. You'd rather Erlington go one-on-one on the block. Portland needs a great possession here.
It's a 9-0 run over the last minute 10 for San Diego. Gorosito pulls up from the elbow. And a putback from Robertson. Much needed basket
nice
right there.
Nice job of crashing the offensive glass by Robertson. And now it's going to be stopped. San Diego doing a really nice job of getting quality looks from the offensive end.
That ended a nearly 3-minute field goal drought for the Pilots. Erlington trying to use the glass, no good. And no call on the putback from Williams Jr. Rebound by Wood.
They got numbers.
Scholin fighting through the body. And we've got a charge call. So that one will go on Scholin, his first, and the team's third.
For Erlington, just did a nice job of reading this, steps over, and picks up the charge. You could see Scholin was going to the rim as soon as he caught that basketball. Mm-hmm. Got to recognize a little step throw at the end and not drawing the contact right there, but smart defense.
Jawar trying to create some space. His pass goes into the corner. I think he was looking for Mike Meadows, who was going to the scores table.
And if you're a Portland Pilot fan, this is really nice to see him back in the ball game. He has been in and out with injury all season long. Came with legs from Eastern Washington. Just a solid guy performance-wise. Can do a variety of different things, and he runs the show a little bit different.
Applewhite also checks in for Portland as Nduka and Gorosito go to the bench. Robertson around Erlington. Touch off the glass is good.
Oh, that was a nice little jump hook right there.
And we talked to Coach Leggins earlier this week. He talked about Erlington and Robertson, kind of the same body, same type of play. Bigger guys that can handle the ball and get down low. And here's that nifty work right there by Robertson.
Well, he's kind of an in-between. He can post you up, especially if he's defending in the guard spot. And he's a hard matchup for people. So, he plays much bigger than he is.
Robertson, 6'6", 225. Erlington, 6'7", 230. Robertson gave him some space. Erlington can't connect. And a couple of Pilots fighting over the rebound. It's taken by Applewhite.
Good job on the boards there. They need stops and not giving San Diego second opportunities. Good read.
Deuce Turner's checked in for the Toreros. Nick Lynch is at the scores table right now.
Senator Bell, number 15. Benoit.
You see nice feet in there, drawing the contact.
Benoit picks up the foul. That'll be his first and the team's second.
Tyler Robertson at the line to shoot two.
Robertson, nearly 80% free throw shooter. Off the mark there.
Well, and a guy that gets to the free throw line quite a bit. Very smart. Again, hard to defend because he'll play inside out. I mean, he can shoot 6 feet behind the three-point line or he'll go post somebody up.
Or as you just mentioned, he'll get to the free throw line. We saw it against Portland State this season. 24 attempts from the free throw line, 22 makes.
Yep.
And a rare 0-for-2 trip for Robertson at the free throw line. Benawal's shot is short. Rebound by Wood.
A little bit quick right there.
Scholin picks up his dribble. Finds Robertson, and he gets fouled by Nick Lynch. Head back to the line, sir. Robertson now with 6 points.
Well, nice entry pass. Again, nice job of drawing the contact and getting himself to the free throw line. You like the fact that, you know, they got hot real quick in the beginning of this game and then went on a little bit of a lull. Instead of shooting the three, they're going inside. And, you know, that opens up the perimeter. And it's just smart basketball.
Dalton up at 17 now. Pilots are on a 7-0 run over the last 90 seconds, making their last three shots. Meanwhile, after San Diego went 5 for 5 from the floor, they have cooled off a bit. They've actually missed their last 6 shots.
Haven't scored in just over 2 minutes. And, you know, both teams kind of smaller lineup where they could switch pretty much multiple positions.
McKinney picks up his dribble, back out to Jawara. 3 over Applewhite is short, and another rebound for Wood. He's got 4. Robertson making a move, gets the ball knocked away and goes out of bounds. It'll stay with the Pilots, and Robertson wanting a foul on that last play. You can sort of see that frustration on his face. Here's another look at it.
Well, you go back to the replay. There's somebody all over his arms. You know, not sure how he did not get a call right there. Good transition D, however, by San Diego.
Dolan still has his dribble, gives it up to Applewhite. And it's Robertson just trying to post up on the block. And a foul on Lynch, that'll be his second. He just checked into the game a few moments ago.
Well, smart on Applewhite's part, because Lynch, obviously he has this disadvantage size-wise and speed-wise. Applewhite just went right by him, and he's gonna come out with those quick 2 fouls.
Jamerson the second checks in, the sophomore from Los Angeles. Showing just inside the 3-point line. That soft touch around the rim gets it to go.
Well, again, great recognition by Portland. They're denying that reversal pass up top. Somebody cuts to the free throw line extension, and they're getting that mid-range jumper.
Portland was down 17-10. They are on a 9-0 run over the last 2.5 minutes. And that's gotten them a 2-point lead.
Well, I think defensively made some intensity changes, and, you know, San Diego hasn't scored in over 3 minutes.
They put up a lot of 3-point attempts as well and have come up empty. Meadows got his defender to bite. Drives to the basket, can't finish, rebound Arlington.
Good take to the rim there, just a miss. But you like the fact that he's aggressive right off the bat, being out for a while, you know what I mean?
Yeah. Turner with it, gives it up to Jawara. Over to McKinney the third. Finally hits the 3. That ends a nearly 4-minute drought for San Diego. And they retake a 1-point lead.
Yeah, just too much space right there. San Diego with the high clip of shooting the 3. They can get it going real quick. You have to make him put it on the ground and keep him in front.
Showing with the screen over to Wood. Under 10 on the shot clock. Wood inside, and he got met by Deuce Turner. And I think they're going to call a foul here first. It's going to be Portland ball. And that foul will be on McKinney the third, his first, the team's 5th foul. As we head to break, San Diego 1-point lead, but it's Robertson keeping the Pilots in it. We'll be right back on the WCC Network. Here's the head coach for San Diego, not Stan Johnson, it's actually Steve Lavin. His first season as the head coach for San Diego's head coaching stops at St. John and UCLA. And now he's got sort of a tough task here taking over this Toreros team that has been stuck near the bottom of the WCC for the last few years. But so far, he's got some positive things going for him.
He sure does. I mean, he's obviously a coach that has a lot of success, big-time programs, and it's just, you know, it's a process. He's got a lot of new guys, a lot of new pieces. It's putting in a new system. You know, people expect things right off the bat, but it's a process, and these guys are getting better and better, and I expect recruiting will make a big difference here in the future.
Absolutely. One of those big transfers for San Diego is that man right there, and that's Eric Williams. Grad transfer from Oregon. Missing that free throw there. Nearly a 75% free throw shooter. Set the scoring record for the Toreros in a single game. 43 points against Utah State earlier this season. Applewhite pulls up. The lefty can't get the bounce. And it looks like Townsend will pick up that foul. First one on him and the sixth team foul. So that'll send Applewhite to the line.
Well, a nice job of attacking from that free throw line extended, taking away the reversal pass up top. And I actually thought he had somebody on the perimeter in that three-point line. I didn't remember who it was, but just a good job of getting himself to the line here. Very athletic. He's got a great explosion step, mid-range game, and he can shoot the three.
Applewhite, the transfer from Mississippi State, comes from Memphis, Tennessee, as Gorosito checks back in, along with Robertson, Schoen, and Meadows to the bench. Applewhite, though, on the season, shooting 69.2% from the free throw line. Had a terrific week of games during PKI against North Carolina, Michigan State, and Villanova. And you could almost say that was sort of his coming out party as a Portland Pilot.
Yeah, and you know, the longer that you are in a system, the more comfortable you get. Coaches get in a better rhythm with just what you can do on and off the floor. And he's been a great addition. And I think, you know, athletically, he adds a different element. He's just so talented. Good defense right there. I'm not sure how that ball got out.
I thought we were going to get a jump ball for a second. Somehow it squirted over to Eric Williams on the block. Off the foot of Robertson. It's a turnover. McKinney quickly up the court. Picks up his dribble. Out to Erlington. Steps into the three. Can't connect.
Oh, great rebound.
Fantastic rebound right there. And it leads to a second chance opportunity and a three-pointer for Jawara.
That's all McKinney right there. Great job on the boards.
He took that one from Nduka, yeah, too.
That's not easy to do.
No, not at all. Jack Perry in the game for Portland. Feed into Robertson, poked away from him by Jawara, and a turnover.
Well, USD doing a nice job defending inside. Portland forcing the issue, trying to go to Robertson. They've got to get ball movement, make the defense shift. And then you have a chance for that play.
Portland hasn't had a field goal in 3 minutes. Hey, and let's just knock that one off the board as that three falls for Gorosito.
Right on time.
6 points now for the freshman from Argentina.
Well, that's the thing. I mean, he can shoot it from deep. You know, you talk to Coach Legs. It's really his game is learning the defensive end of things. And he's getting better and better.
He's got all the confidence in the world with the ball in his hand. He's got that extra flair to him, too. You love to see on the offensive end. Here's a drive from Erlington. And that one will go against Nduka. That'll be his second. And the sixth Portland foul. So that's something that you're going to have to keep an eye on with Nduka picking up his second foul here. And we still have 8 minutes to go in the first half.
Well, Erlington doing a great job of just squaring up, going one-on-one to the rim. And, you know, his strength and size, the combination of it, the Pilots having a hard time stopping him.
Erlington now 3 for 3 from the charity stripe. He's got 7 points. As Vasily Vucinic checks in for Nduka, along with Moses Wood for Jack Perry. Erlington, a senior transfer from St. John's. Missing that free throw, and the Pilots Almost gave up a free rebound right there.
A little miscommunication, but got it back.
Devin Dahlke has checked in. He's working on Robertson on the block. You have to think that's probably where Portland's trying to go right now. And there's the double team on Robertson. Kicks it out to Applewhite. Another three for Portland. That's four now in the first half. And you had your hands up there. Did you think you saw a foul there?
Well, it just, again, they're forcing that issue. A great catch on Robertson's part. I mean, it's like as soon as he's catching it, he's got somebody. What's he going to do with it, right? Mm-hmm. Lucky enough on balance to get it to the three-point shooter. And there's a huge answer right there by Townsend for San Diego.
Townsend now with 6 points. And you're right, though. He was falling to the ground, just knew that Gorosito was over there and was just able to get that pass to him.
San Diego, 6 of 13 from the three.
Wood drives, picks up his dribble, kicks it out to Gorosito. Fake pass, now over to Robertson in the corner. It's long, rebound Townsend, lead pass up.
They like to go quick.
Turner pulls up in front of Wood and knocks it down.
This USD team's got a lot of talented guards and the pace, it's frantic. You want to go and transition D is going to be huge down the road here.
Spin by Applewhite was stopped. Vucinic couldn't get the tip to go. And a blocking call. It's going to be on Gorosito. That'll be his first and the team's seventh foul. Pilots trailing by four, just under 6.5 minutes left to go until halftime. The deep threat for the Pilots, Gorosito hitting a three. We'll be right back. WCC Network. Welcome back inside the Child Center. San Diego with a 4-point lead right now over the University of Portland. And they're shooting 46.2% from behind the arc. 6 of 13 here in this first half. And that certainly helped them out with this 4-point lead so far, Jennifer.
Well, you look at the stat sheet, and both teams actually shooting pretty well from the field, 46, 50%. It's turnovers right now. Portland has six turnovers that have led to 8 USD points. And we knew that both teams were going to shoot a ton of threes.
Yep. Townsend, the senior transfer from Denver, hits both free throws. Leads the conference in free throw percentage at nearly 88%. So one of the last guys you want to put on the line. San Diego on a 6-0 run over the last 2 minutes. Arlington denying the entry pass for Vucinic. Robertson gets fouled, he'll head to the line.
Really smart play by Robertson, realized that he had a step on him, lowers his shoulder, takes the contact. He took it right to the chin.
Yes, he did. Dahlke will pick up that foul.
Taylor Robertson at the line to shoot one.
Well, I like what USD is doing defensively. They're denying the reversal pass. Portland sometimes not able to get the ball to the second side and staying kind of, you know, in that forcing issue, trying to get it down low where help side is just sitting and waiting.
I was going to say, you're not having that defense move exactly over. So a three-point lead now after the three-point play by Robertson. Robertson has 10 points already. Three different Toreros closing in on double digits. Townsend, step back three, Overwood almost knocked it down. It's an offensive rebound by Jawara.
So Vucinic has got to put a body on him down low.
And that pass will go out of bounds and no touch from Portland. It's Pilot basketball.
And that's the Torero's second turnover of the game. Been pretty clean so far.
To Vucinic, the extra pass to the corner to Robertson, finds an open Wood on the wing. Three doesn't go, and a rebound for Townsend.
That's a good offensive possession, good ball movement, and a great look.
Townsend backing down the freshman. Step by, off the glass, no good, rebound Robertson.
Good defense by Gorzito there.
Robertson quickly down the lane, pass Irwington.
Well, again, just a smart play. Realized that he had him on his side. No help side defense from the top there, and a nice finish by Robertson.
He's got 12 points, two rebounds, and three assists. Irwington squares up and knocks down the mid-range jumper over Vucinic.
Well, he's got 9 points in this half so far, and really a scored at will. Good pass.
And Robertson again underneath. He's got 14.
Vucinic, which with a nice assist right there. Good recognition.
These two teams just trading baskets right now. Irwington now with double digits. He's got 12 points, three rebounds, and two assists.
Well, you can see he scored at the block. He scored at the free throw line. He scored mid-range. Can shoot the three. And there's a nice high-low option right there. Leggins wants a timeout.
Leggins will get that timeout. Portland has made their last three shots. And that will extend to a full timeout for Portland. So 4:03 left to go until halftime. The Pilots are back within two. It's a close one here inside the Child Center. Don't go anywhere on the WCC Network. Call him the fridge. And let me tell you, he has been fantastic so far. 14 points, three assists. And that's the young man from Melbourne, Australia, Tyler Robertson, who's Mr. Do-It-All for the Pilots. And he's really just become the face of this university from the basketball standpoint.
He really has. And it's not necessarily just his play on the court. it's who he has, who he is as a guy. I mean, he has embraced this culture. He is a leader. He does everything right on and off the floor. And really, I mean, he sails out every single night trying to get a win for this Pilot squad.
Burlington knocks out another mid-range jumper. This time it's over Wood. I mean, going back to Robertson, I mean, he's a guy after practice, he's coming up, shaking your hand. He's going to come over before the game, say hello.
Yep.
Yeah, that's just who he is. And I think that goes a long way, especially for the Portland faithful. They love to see that interaction as he gets another tough basket down low.
Well, they've been really smart. You know, they've adjusted a little bit. And really, they have not, USD has not been able to stop him inside. 18 points in the paint right now, and that last timeout, I think there were six. So you see that huge adjustment right there. I've not fallen in love with the three, but it opens up the three-point line by scoring in the paint.
Jawar kicks it out to McKinney the third. He lost it. Taken away by Gorosito. Here's a scrum on the floor. They find Irwington near the basket, and he's got a layup.
Well, great job by McKinney staying with that play because that was going the other way.
So Irwington and Robertson, the two guys, similar frames, are going at it. They both got 16 points so far in the first half.
Yeah, both have been terrific.
Robertson 7 of 10 from the floor. Irwington 6 of 11.
San Diego in a little bit of a zone here out of that timeout.
Meadows back in the game along with Nduka. Quick pass to Wood, far wing. And another three for the Pilots. Wood has 8 points and 5 rebounds.
Well, a great job of going to that middle of the zone and then a quick pass to the perimeter. Good ball movement and good patience.
Both teams red hot. Pilots have hit their last 5 shots. San Diego, it was 4 straight, but now 4 of their last 5. Gorosito, man on a mission, driving, and he gets blocked, but he's fouled.
Well, when he gets a full head of steam, you know, coming up the court like that, he's going to be hard to stop.
That foul's going to be on Deuce Turner.
He sees the paint right there. Nice job again. Got fouled on the way down.
Gorosito at the free throw line, 75% free throw shooter.
Well, we knew this one was going to be a high scoring game.
Yes, we did.
And it is not disappointing. I mean, like you said, Portland 5 of their last 5 and San Diego 4 of their last 5. So it's going to be who's going to get a defensive stop here in the second half.
Gorosito will go 2 for 2 from the line. And the freshman from Argentina has 8 points now. Career high is 14. Townsend backs off Gorosito. Jawara somehow found Townsend through a sea of Pilots, and he throws it off of a Pilot defender. It'll stay with the Toreros.
Well, I really feel, I mean, the last two possessions, defensively, Portland doing a much better job of putting ball pressure.
Turner, that three's not going to go. And the ball finds its way over to Meadows.
Good patience. Good transition D by San Diego to slow it up.
Nduka backing down Williams. Size advantage to Nduka as he gets fouled. And that should be on Williams. It will be. That'll be his first personal.
Well, Nduka did a really good job there of taking the body contact. He might have got away with a little arm push, but nice little jump hook. Falling away.
18 fouls for San Diego so far, as Nduka will miss that free throw. 51.4% free throw shooter. Robertson goes to the bench. Applewhite on the court now for Portland. And Robertson needs that breather. He's been working his tail off in this first half. Nduka hits the second, and it's a 2-point lead for Portland with just over a minute to go until halftime. Jawara tried to feed Irwington, finds an open Williams, baits Applewhite to go by, And great athleticism right there by Williams to hold off the defender and Wood.
Oh my goodness, great help side defense. He was there and just great hang time and a great individual play.
Applewhite crosses over, finds Meadows near the corner. Mike Meadows, his first points.
Well, you'd like to see the explosion out of Meadows there, right there. You know, he's had a groin injury. He didn't look like he's hurting whatsoever with that, right? Great baseline drive.
Yeah, not one bit. About a half second between game clock and shot clock. Game clock being a bit quicker. High pass to Jawara. In the corner to Williams. Sort of double clutch, followed his own shot, and he can't get the put back before the buzzer. Pilots were fortunate right there to not give up that easy put back to Williams.
And you see his athleticism right there. Shoots the three and immediately to the rim, off, almost cut that offensive board and put back.
Well, the Pilots holding on to a two-point lead going into halftime, 46-44. These two teams going up and down the court nonstop. We'll be right back. Talk about the first half and some stats when we return.
This is Maria. Maria banks with CCCU. She has a first-time home buyer savings account and a dog named Dave. She plays pickup soccer. She's about to get a mortgage and loves listening to music. She's just the kind of member that can take advantage of everything CCCU has to offer.
And I just like what credit unions stand for.
From customer to customized. Bank locally, live simply with CCCU.
What is our way? Our way is unrelenting, imposing as the mountaintops to our east, strong as the ocean to our west. Our way is forward, challenged by past achievement, expecting future success. Our way is committed, devoted, passionate. Our way fuels us to be different, to be inspired, to have faith in each other. What is our way? Our way is West.
Some people might call it a job. I call it a mission, helping people get back on their way. When you're a roadside technician for AAA, every day is different. We're always ready to be there for you when your call comes in. I love seeing that smile on a member's face when you get them rolling again. It makes you feel good. At the end of the day, it's all about helping people. That's what keeps me going.
Even when I was little, just growing up, I knew I wanted to play in college.
I've kind of always just wanted to go here, so I'd come out to the games and like sit in the stands and see them. And like, I genuinely believed that I could be one of them.
Being on the court felt like nothing else mattered.
I just thought it was fun.
I've always been not the most athletic, not the tallest, not the skinniest.
I know what it's like to feel like you can't do it, but you really can.
I play to prove others wrong.
Go, Goose, go!
I find purpose in making the people who supported me proud.
Trust that all the hard work you've put in is going to pay off. Go out there and try to prove each and every person wrong that's ever doubted you.
Running a race is one of the most physically and mentally challenging things, but crossing that finish line, that feeling just can't be matched.
Competing feels like I'm on top of the world.
All it takes is one conversation.
I'm just proud of their team performance.
All it takes is one opportunity to be successful.
Pick 10, they're in the championship round. Like, what can you tell me? I mean, what a celebration to have.
Being in the stands as a little girl and now being on the court, being able to represent myself and the game and University of Portland.
I used to see myself as just a basketball player. Now I see myself as a role model.
Here's to the next gen.
welcome back inside the Child Center. Brian Slyke and Jennifer Mountain with the call, and it was an exciting first half between these two up and down the court. 46-44. It's a two-point lead for the Pilots as we close in on the final few minutes of halftime. And, Jen, I can't say that we were surprised. We knew this was probably coming between these two teams. I think the more shocking part is how many shots were really put up in that first half from both sides.
Well, we knew this was going to be a fast-paced game, and threes galore by both sides. But, I mean, right now, San Diego has 22 on the season is their average. They have 18 and a half already. So they're on their way, well on their way to above average shooting from the three. But, you know, I think it's really going to come down to defensive stops here in this second half. Both teams shooting really well. 61.5% from the field for Portland. And then 45% from the field for San Diego. And then from the three-point line, Portland 50% and San Diego just under 40%. So both teams shooting at a very high clip. You know, I think the biggest thing is they went to Tyler Robinson inside, you know, 20-12 in the paint production for Portland. And I think that was a big adjustment, I guess, in that first half. And he was unstoppable. I mean, you take him and then you take Erlington from the other side, both of them kind of at will were able to score. And he just did a really good job of scoring inside, using his body. You know, he hit a three earlier in the half, and that kind of opened things up for him. But a great, I think, execution-wise, getting him in the paint and involved early.
Well, Robertson just so strong. You're looking at a few of his plays right now, and he's always got a body up on him. And this is the one that really gets me, because Erlington's ready for him. He's expecting Robertson to go slow, and then he blows right by him for the layup.
And Erlington is quick, athletic,
yes,
and strong, and just a great explosion step right there to get to the rim. I mean, one of the things we talked about is the pace of play, and right now, fast break favors Portland 10-5. I would not have called that the first half.
We kept thinking about how San Diego was probably going to run away in that category, but Portland has been holding their own, but San Diego still setting the tempo, though, quickly down the court as we are just about to start this second half. Now, one of the things to keep an eye on, a little bit of foul trouble for some Pilots. Robertson's got two, and Duca's got two, and then so does Schoen. So that's three of your starters that have two fouls.
Well, they have to be smart right from the beginning. You don't want to pick up a quick one. But at the same time, you got to, you know, play your own game. And those three especially, I would say Robertson and Schoen really have to be smart here. I mean, Nduka, he has a hard task. I mean, he's matched up against Erlington. And those two just really going at it physically down low.
And one other note. Exciting things that happened in that first half. Moses Wood has 8 points. He now has 1,001 career points in his college career across Tulane and UNLV, and now here with the Portland Pilots, so the newest member of the 1,000-point club as well.
Well, congratulations to Moses Wood. Hopefully he has a few more in his arsenal here in this second half. Love to see him healthy, that's for sure.
Yeah, I mean, we've talked about San Diego and how athletic they are. They brought in a whole bunch of transfers. One thing that you don't realize, with a lot of transfers coming in, these guys had a lot of play. They've got five different players that are 1,000-point scorers on their roster.
Now, there's not too many teams that can probably say that.
No, they lead the nation in that category.
The thing about bringing in so many transfers, and, you know, you're overhauling a program. Just getting them to gel. And with this portal situation left and right, and Schoen's going to pick one up right there.
Yeah, and he just picked up his third foul there, and I saw the frustration on Legan's face that you're not even
30 seconds into it. That's exactly what we just talked about.
You're 12 seconds, or 22 seconds into this half. And a turnover for San Diego.
Yeah, he either stepped on the inline there or he moved his feet, and that was a dead ball. He can't move on that one, and San Diego's going to pick up full court here, try to turn Portland over a little bit.
Six turnovers in the first half for Portland. Robertson with it. Feed to Nduka, and denied by McKinley.
great help side defense. I mean, he came from the opposite baseline. It's a good read off the little pick and roll and great athleticism. I mean, we've seen a couple plays by McKinney so far in this half. Just shows you his athleticism.
Mm-hmm. Wood puts up the three and it rattles home. He's got 11 points now. And that'll open up a 5-point lead for Portland.
Great job by Wood coming off the down screen, getting his feet set and a quick pull.
McKinney on Scholin. Drives by the big man and a put back by Eric Williams.
Woo-hoo.
My goodness.
Well, you talk about athleticism right there. Great follow.
It's Pilots trying to set up their offense. Now they spread out the floor. Everybody was on the far side for a moment. Schoen getting some space around Williams. And Schoen trying to return the favor. Gets denied by Williams, but a foul.
Well, Williams and Schoen really battling down low. You see the physicality. And Scholin tried to dunk that right over the top of him, and he had no part of that.
Well, Williams not happy with that call on him.
No.
That'll be the second one on Williams and the first one by the Toreros in this half. Portland has gotten to the free throw line a lot. 12 times in the first half. They went 9 for 12 as Scholin front iron off the backboard and in on that free throw attempt. He now has 5 points to go along with 2 rebounds and an assist. So 2 for 2 for the Pilots from the stripe right there by Scholin. Applewhite will come onto the floor. Scholin, with his 3 fouls, will find his way to the bench.
I think that was a really smart sub by Legs, because they were starting to kind of get into it down low, and you certainly don't want to pick up a quick one, another quick one, and have 4 fouls at this time in the ball game.
Yeah, you're right with how Williams and Scholin were going against each other, because Williams was on the block against Scholin, and it looked like Irwington got blocked, and it'll be Pilot basketball.
Applewhite coming from behind with the block. Great defense. Great team defense. Here he comes from the backside.
You see Irwington, he knew it went off of his hand too. So just the 3rd turnover for the Toreros in this game.
Yeah, pretty clean game overall.
9 turnovers overall.
The intensity level on both sides is really starting to step up here. Oh, good feed inside.
And Wood touches off the glass, and he's got 13 points.
Great job, because they had Wanzi coming off a double screen, so there was no help side defense. And Robertson saw him inside. Nice feed.
McKinney trying to create some separation after picking up his dribble. Gets it out to Irwington. The near wing, Wood on defense. Applewhite comes over, and he gets the steal. Irwington wanted a foul. The feed up to Robertson. Applewhite sidesteps, can't get the finish, and a rebound for Williams. An empty trip for the Pilots.
Well, unfortunate, because he had a point-blank layup.
Wood went straight up, no foul called. Irwington cleans up.
That's a big swing right there. You miss a layup and give up one.
Irwington now leads all scorers with 18. Go along with 4 rebounds and 2 assists. Applewhite's feed to Wood. It looked like McKinney had the arm of Wood, so he couldn't get that pass. It'll go out of bounds and stay with the Pilots.
Well, you don't want to fall in love with it.
Yeah, we saw a couple turnovers in that first half because of forcing it in there just like that.
Well, you see how deep the pass is. I mean, you're bringing him all the way underneath the hoop. Even if he does catch it, tough position to score. Credit USD, though, the defense. Good job of getting by right there.
Yep, shot clock was winding down. They were under 5. Stephen Jamison, the second, picks up that foul. His first and the 2nd team foul. Quick quick inbound to Wood, trying to catch the Toreros off guard, inside to Nduka, and he can't get that basket to go. Jawara, pass across court to Irwington, and a hard foul by Moses Wood, and they're going to count that one. Wood can't believe it.
I'm not sure how you count that bucket.
Well, I think he just changed that one to on the ground. And they did change it to on the ground, so that basket does not count. You see the initial, whoa. So the inbound for San Diego. And that one might be on Applewhite. It is. That'll be his first. And the team's third.
Well, this game's getting real physical inside.
I mean,
everybody that's posting up is getting body contact. That last trip, I mean, they called the foul obviously on Wood, but I mean, Duca.
Yeah, he had the body right on him.
Good curl.
Jawara, the push on Nduka, and he gets called for the charge.
That's what Chica does right there. He baits you into it and did a nice job stepping over. And they're lucky because he was in the restricted
circle. Yeah, I was going to say, his back foot was in the restricted zone.
He was on the ball handler, though, so it doesn't matter.
5-point lead for Portland as we close in on the first media break. Gorosito, the fast ball handles, gives it up to Applewhite, and he traveled.
Good call. Got going a little too quick there. He's come in and given them some good minutes here.
He has. And that's sort of the difference in this, from this game, from other games, is usually Applewhite, with the injuries that Portland has been in the starting lineup, but they went small with Gorosito and Nduka in the starting lineup tonight. Williams with an air ball. Lavin wanted a foul. And that'll send us to the break. 53-48, a 5-point lead for the Portland Pilots. 15:50 left to go in tonight's action. We'll be right back on the WCC Network. Welcome back inside the Child Center. Brian Slyke and Jennifer Mountain with your call. These two teams have been playing hard against each other. Portland has not scored in over 2 minutes, though. San Diego just trying to get a basket as a shot clock down to 5. Extra pass from Irwington off the hands of Williams, and you see the frustration on the young man's face.
Well, because he was wide open down low and easy, too, and unfortunate there for San Diego. San Diego doing a terrific job on the offensive boards in this first 4.5 minutes. They've got 5 O boards.
Yeah, we were just talking about that at the break, and it's led to some opportunities for them. Foul call on Eric Williams Jr. That'll be his third.
Portland's done a nice job of taking away the three. They've only had one three-point shot in the first 4.5 minutes of this half. Obviously something that, you know, changed.
Yeah, 18 in the first half for San Diego to only one. I mean, we were talking about in the first half, 10 three-point shots in 10 minutes, basically, for the Toreros.
Well, good adjustment by the Pilots out of halftime.
And a sub as Deuce Turner will check in. Sigu Jawara heads to the bench.
Moses Wood with 15 points in the game.
Here's Townsend with it on the near wing. Turner goes by Meadows. Picks up his dribble and hesitation on the pass leads to a turnover.
Good steal, good hands by Applewhite. Ooh.
Pass to Meadows in the corner, the open three!
Well, that's a tough shot when you've been in the ball game for about 15 seconds sitting on the bench, but Applewhite right there really made that play happen.
Moses Wood had 8 points at halftime. As that basket goes for San Diego, and that ends a scoring drought of 2 minutes. But 8 points at halftime for Wood. He already has 7 points in under 6 minutes in this half. San Diego needed that last basket bad. Not only had they not scored in a couple minutes, but they had 4 turnovers over the last 3.5 minutes. Behind the back, Applewhite! Filthy around Turner.
Well, he's doing it on both ends of the floor, defensively, making things happen, and then great job making decisions and then scoring in the half court.
Townsend drives, keeps his foot on the ground, gives it up to Turner. Fade away over Meadows.
Tough
sticks
shot.
It.
Tough shot.
And a timeout call by San Diego. 14:06 on the clock until the end of this one. It's an 8-point lead for the Pilots. 60-52. As we roll on, we head to break. Pilots look to hold on to this lead. It's Applewhite with some nifty moves right there. We'll be right back on the WCC Network. Alden Applewhite, one of the new additions for the Pilots this season, and he's certainly shown out in his time on the bluff as he's helped the Pilots get out to an 8-point lead over the Toreros. And Jen, we're closing in about halfway through this second half, and what have you noticed from these two teams at the start?
Well, I think the defensive intensity on both sides has really picked up, especially for Portland. They're doing a good job of getting great shots in the half court, getting people involved. I mean, you talk about Applewhite. In just less than 16 minutes, he's got 7 points, 4 rebounds, 4 assists, and 2 steals.
He's efficient in his time out there.
Absolutely, just athletic. I feel like they've taken away the three-point threat from San Diego, which has been huge. San Diego's turned it over a little bit higher clip this half.
As you see the two big guys battle it out, bumping bodies as Erlington will head to the free throw line for what would be his third three-point play opportunity. He had 2 in the first half. This is the first time he heads to the line in the second half.
Well, the thing about him is he's, again, so strong. I mean, he's battling inside, getting pushed, bumped, and able to take the contact and finish.
Erlington has 20 points. His career high is 25 that he set back in 2019 when they faced off against Creighton. San Diego's hit their last 3 shots, too, so Torero's starting to heat up as Erlington now gets his third three-point play, and he's got 21 points. 4 of 5 from the charity stripe, 8 of 14 from the floor.
When San Diego's gonna switch to a zone out of that timeout. Portland did a nice job against the zone in the first half when they went to it.
Applewhite's pass. Got a hand on it was Eric Williams Jr. It'll stay with the Pilots. Gorosito checks back in. Meadows will go to the bench.
Get a lot of perimeter shooters right here in this ball club.
And there's one of them. It's Gorosito!
And that's exactly why he came in the game right there, is to extend that zone. They've got to come out. It opens up in the inside. Good sub by Legs right there.
One of the few guys you see the shot go up and you think it's going in right away. He shoots 40% from the three-point line. He's knocked down 3 of them so far tonight. He's got 11 points.
Good defense by Robertson right there with the jump ball.
And they will get that jump ball. It'll go towards the Pilots. And Robertson, a key defensive play right there to cool off the Toreros, who've hit their last 3 shots.
I actually like that matchup with the two of them defending each other inside.
Erlington and Robertson?
Yes. San Diego staying in the zone.
Applewhite squares up for the 3. It was halfway down and out. An offensive board by Wood. Applewhite around the defender. 9 points for Applewhite.
Well, a second chance opportunity because Wood on the offensive glass. And San Diego going a little too fast right there by Townsend.
Almost seemed like a panicked or rushed 3 on that possession. A
lot of time left in this ball game.
10-point lead for the Pilots. Feed pass broken up by the Toreros, and Townsend ends up with it. Williams steps into the transition 3. He's got it.
Well, we talked about how fast they can get up the floor.
He's got 14 points. San Diego hitting 4 of their last 5 shots.
San Diego matched back up.
Yep, back to a man defense. Wood got the separation he wanted on the curl. Another mid-range jumper.
It's just so dangerous coming off screens.
17.
Great footwork.
Townsend gets the handoff from Turner. Turner, a deep 3.
Probably a little too deep right there, but not a bad look.
Robertson quickly to the corner, trying to catch his man off guard. Williams has 3 fouls, and I think he just picked up his 4th.
Robertson just, again, so smart of just baiting him into this. Got him on his hip and a great little spin move back, and he picks up a big foul.
Yeah, that's the 4th foul on Williams Jr. And that'll send us to the media break. 10:59 left in this one. It's a 9-point lead for the Pilots, 67-58. We'll be right back on the WCC Network. think he's got already, Jen?
At least 15,000.
He's one of the most energetic coaches on the sideline that I've ever seen. He's up and down every single possession, stomping his feet, yelling things out. He's more involved even though he's off the court.
Very passionate, let's just put it that way.
As Robertson steps to the free throw line, he's got 16 points. He's 2 for 4. So he missed the first two from the free throw line to start the night. He misses that one. Junior's
don't
averaging.
See that very often.
Yeah, he's averaging nearly 14 and a half points and nearly an 80% free throw shooter as well, as he goes 50% on this trip. And Duca will come onto the floor. Robertson to the bench.
Also in the lineup for the Pilots.
Jawara and McKinney the third have checked in for San Diego. Jawara with it right there, gives it up to McKinney the third. Almost seemed like he got an extra step there. Offensive rebound by Irwington and the putback. Irwington has 23 points. He is now two away from his career high.
11th offensive board for San Diego, 7.5.
Yeah. And that's a lot.
And that's a jump ball right there. Good defense by San Diego. Goes back to Toreros. A lot of time left, and the way that San Diego can shoot the basketball, you're never out of it. Have to defend if you're the Pilots.
Well, just a moment ago, it was a 10-point lead for Portland. It seemed like they had all the momentum as Nduka gets called for the foul. That'll be his third. But even though it's an 8-point game, it's not like San Diego's really rallied back, but certainly you feel that momentum go towards the Toreros.
Yeah, and Irwington again doing a great job of just backing somebody down. And it's hard because if you're going one-on-one on the block, you want to have that wing player kind of, you know, dump down and try to give some help, but they kick it back out for the three, you're in trouble.
Irwington trying to set a new career high. He's closing in on it with that made free throw. He's got 24 points. Career high is 25 that he set back in 2019 at Creighton. As Robertson checks back in, Applewhite to the bench.
Well, Applewhite came in and did great, great things on both ends of the floor.
As Irwington has tied that career high now with 25 points. But you're right, Applewhite efficient in the minutes that he's had, especially coming off the bench tonight when normally he's been a starter due to some of the injuries for the Pilots.
Yeah, just so athletic and certainly something that they're going to need.
Feed into Sholin, kicks it to Nduka, and the baseline jumper goes.
Good job by Sholin, getting double teamed again on that catch. And finding Nduka for that sweet little mid-range jumper.
And I want to go back to Applewhite for a second. I mean, talk about a guy who's been starting the last few games and now coming off the bench, but he's still got that tenacity, that mindset to still attack the basket and not let that affect him. As that three is short, rebound by Jawara, pulls it right back up, and he puts it back in.
Well, Legg's not happy with that because that's a defensive mistake right there. Gorzito goes to double team, leaves somebody wide open on the offensive glass, and they give up a three.
So now it's a 5-point lead for Portland. It's dwindling away, 70-65. We'll be right back on the WCC Network. It's leading by 5. Brian Slyke and Jennifer Mountain on your calls. We're inside the Child Center with under 9.5 minutes left to go in this one after timeout call by Portland. Pilot basketball, Robertson off iron and a rebound for San Diego.
Had a lot of success with that kind of drive in the first half. looking to go back at it. Oh, good hands.
Irwington's next basket will be a career high, and he's got it right there. 28 points now, a new career high for Irwington.
Well, he is feeling it.
Pilots keep it on the outside. As that lead, they were up by 10 just a few minutes ago, now down to two.
With San Diego on a 6-0 run right now. Pilots looking to respond.
Duca wanted a foul call. He was getting pushed around in the paint. Meadows, the open lane, and he lost it on the way up. Irwington driving, and he should be on the ground for that one. And they're gonna mark him on the ground. And that foul will be on Robertson. That'll be his third. And the sixth team foul.
Yeah, good call. Swiping in at the ball.
Gorosito will get a breather. Wood back on the court now. And this is one of those moments where you might want to take that freshman off the court and get one of those veteran presents in Wood on the floor. You're only up by two now with under 8.5.
Well, you know, you talked about the defensive intensity. It's dropped a little bit, but just miscommunication and assignments. You know, talking to Legs, that's the one area that he's getting better at, just not quite there yet. You can't afford mistakes like that one with the giving up the three.
Jawar gets the screen. Schoen closing out, and it doesn't matter. Jawara, 12 points now after he just hit his fourth three of the game.
Well, San Diego on a 9-0 run here. Just too soft of a closeout.
Not only is it a 9-0 run, it's a 13-2 run over the last 2.5 minutes. And it looks like that foul is going to be called on Portland. It's Anduka, and that'll be his fourth.
Well, a nice take. Robinson thought he got some body right there, but Portland on a scoring drought of just over 2 minutes. Just can't afford it at this time in the ball game, giving up a 10-point lead.
Yep, and now you trail by 171-70, and some things just have not really gone their way. You have a defensive breakdown, a couple of turnovers, and some quick shots that just don't go, and then you see San Diego take it the other way. They've got a couple of second-chance opportunities that they've capitalized on. Here's some of the stats that we have going in to this half, and points in the paint. Portland had a huge lead in that category at halftime. I believe it was around 20-8, and now it's 24 all.
20-12 at halftime, you know, but like you said, it's right now, the momentum has totally shifted into San Diego. They're scoring at will, going inside out, miscommunication and assignments defensively. If you're Portland, there's a lot of time left in this ball game. Both squads making runs.
And you have to close out. Box out your man. 12 offensive rebounds right now for San Diego. And I believe 8 of those have come in this second half alone. And it's led to 18 second chance points for the Toreros in this game.
Yeah, second chance points in the first half, they only had 5. So you can see the outcome right there from just, you know, being aggressive and getting to the rim. So if you're the Pilots out of this timeout, you've got to make a defensive shift. The intensity level's got to raise. The urgency's got to raise. And then offensively, ball movement. San Diego, they want to push tempo. They want to get creative. Give the ball to Irwington and let him go.
He certainly is the hot hand right now with 28 points, a career high. He's tied his career high in field goals made as well with 10. His next basket will give him a career high in that one. But he is looking to add on to a career night in the scoring category.
They just have had, they have not had an answer for him.
Irwington got that one to go. He's 7-for-8 from the free throw line tonight. On the season, Irwington is a 78.4% free throw shooter. As Jace Townsend will come in.
Well, like you said, 3 of them were on the traditional and one opportunities, the old-fashioned three-point play.
And now you see Portland make a change as Anduka, who now has 4 fouls, goes to the bench. Vucinic comes out. Erlington goes 2 for 2, and he now has 30 points.
We'll look for Portland to get Moses Wood involved a little bit. He's had a lot of success. Ooh.
He got cut off by McKinley, the third right there. Vucinic trying to get around his man. It was halfway down and out before McKinley skied for that rebound. 15-2 run over the last 3 minutes. Portland has not made a basket in their last four shots.
Yeah, just almost two and a half minutes without a bucket.
Jawar trying to break down Robertson. Got some separation and can't get the bounce.
Good board by Sholin.
He's been relatively quiet tonight. Six points and only three rebounds now. Gorosito off the bench and at the scores table. He'll come in, next dead ball. Great feed into Vucinic, who got the separation from his man. He's got an easy two.
Well, great catch. I mean, I didn't know if he was gonna go get that. Had to release to get that ball to the rim. Good pass by Robertson.
Back to a 1-point lead for San Diego.
That's a tough matchup right there.
Big size advantage. Erlington wanted to create some space. Smarty didn't collect that foul. Jawara in the paint using the left hand.
Well, we talked about one-on-one with the ball, and right now San Diego doing a great job of breaking down the defense, and that is deep three by Sholin. Woo!
There's that, some of that action you want to see from Sholin with that deep three. He's now got 9 points.
That was 10 feet behind the line.
Man's got range. So 75 all as we close in. Under 6 minutes left in this one.
Let's see if Portland can get something going with that kind of a shot.
Add some energy into the building. You can hear the fans get into it now. Drive from Erlington. Tried to give it up. He got the ball back. And Leggins wants to travel on that one, but I think he let the ball go, and then it came back to him.
It came out. It got knocked out or something and was able to re-catch the basketball and then the finish. Unlucky for Portland, but a nice, strong take by Erlington.
He's got 32 points. San Diego's hit 5 of their last 6 shots. Ball poked away right into the hands of Robertson. Pass inside to Vucinic. 5 on the shot clock. Turns, goes baseline, pass to Wood. Oh!
Well, you can see better offensive flow for the Pilots right there. It's going to be, again, it's going to come down to defensive stops. There's 5 minutes left in this game. Who's going to step it up and get stops?
One of the impressive parts of this, they've been relying on Erlington, but one of their best players, Eric Williams Jr., has been out for a long stretch because of 4 fouls as McKinley almost benefited from that loose ball being tipped in. As Williams Jr.'s will come in on the next dead ball, poked away by Townsend. Robertson, no foul call. Jawara cleans it up. And Jawara now has 16 points. 2-point lead, under 4.5 left to go.
Well, the thing about that one is you turn it over, you got to get back and try to make a play. Nice job by Robertson right there.
Robertson will have another opportunity. He himself has gotten to the line for a 3-point play a few times tonight. And here again.
It's a strength right there. Nice little spin back, little jump hook, took the contact.
Now, free throw line has been an issue for Robertson tonight. He's 3 for 6, nearly an 80% free throw shooter.
Yeah, if you're Coach Legs, though, you still want him to have that basketball at the free throw line at the end of the game.
Absolutely. He's the one guy you trust.
Yep.
To get that basket for you. Jawara.
3 of 7 on the night. Well, we knew it was going to be a high-scoring game. We talked about it. Both teams at 80 already.
Yep. Erlington step back over Robertson.
Ooh!
Almost had that one.
That was halfway down. I'll tell you, he doesn't need much room to get a shot off.
No, he does not. Pilots have hit their last 4 shots. That's what's keeping them in it right now, as it's 79 all. Nobody was on Wood for a moment. Fade away. Make it look easy. 21 points for Wood.
Well, he's had a great second half.
He really has. Only had 8 points in that first half.
Oh, good job by Applewhite coming over for the jump ball. Oh, they're going to call a foul.
And they're going to call a foul on Applewhite. And you hear it from the fans. They're not happy with that call. They wanted a jump ball, and well, here you get a replay. It looks like he got his hand completely on that ball.
Just bad angle, I guess.
Yeah.
Again, you love his hustle, his determination, and again, anticipation of that pass.
All right, Jen, you used to be that head coach. In these types of situations, you're up by two with a little over 3 minutes left in this one. If you're on Portland's bench, what are you telling your players right now to try to slow down San Diego?
It's all about the defensive end right now. They have the ability to score points. That's not an issue. I mean, look at the score right now. It's got to be, you got to get the ball out of Erlington's hand. You can't let him get him back. You've got to rebound every single time in all five spots. Nobody can miss an assignment there. And it's going to be down a 3.5 minutes of just flat out getting stops. You got to lock in defensively, and you really got to do a good job of keeping the ball in front. Right now, San Diego is breaking them down left and right, and they've got to do a better job of keeping it in front.
And you want to limit those second chance points. 29 rebounds for San Diego tonight. 13 of them have come on the offensive side. That's way too many for Portland to be giving up, especially in this tight of a contest this late in the game.
Especially 8 in this second half. I mean, they had 5 at halftime. That's a lot of chances to score.
So Erlington with 32, Sisoho Jawara with 16, and then you've got Eric Williams Jr. with 14.
Well, they've got four guys that, you know, average a double-double, and it's usually not somebody going off for 30 like Erlington tonight, but been very solid. So, you know, and on the flip side there, you got Wood with 21, Robertson with 19. Gorzito, 11, yeah. Applewhite, 9, and Scholin with 9. I mean, you got almost five guys in double figures.
I think it's big. You've got Gorzito getting involved with his 11 points. I mean, he already has the confidence, but if he starts pouring it in, it's only going to go higher. As Jawara is at the line for his bonus attempt. Has not attempted a free throw yet. And his first one rattles home. San Diego's 11 for 13 from the free throw line tonight. Portland 14 of 19. And I think that's also been a big part of this game because Portland had a large lead in that category throughout the first half. And in the second half, San Diego's gotten to the line, stopped the clock, and gotten back into this one.
Yep, back into that zone out of the timeout. Every time that San Diego has gone to the zone, Portland has been very effective.
10 on the shot clock. Tie ball game, 81 all. Robertson gives it up to Wood. Quickly over to Gorosito. He's got to put a shot up.
Oh.
Behind the back to Nduka. Beautiful.
Nice behind the back bounce pass. There's that flare. Nice find.
'83-'81, under 2.5 left to go. Jawara, spin move around Wood. Gives it up, and Williams had it in his hands. Ball still loose on the floor. Gorosito, like a toddler, crawling for it. And a timeout called by San Diego.
Wow. San Diego.
There's 3 seconds left on the shot clock for San Diego. But what a sequence of plays right there.
I don't know how you call a timeout. I don't think anybody had possession on that ball.
You see Gorosito just trying to get to the ball.
I mean, I don't know.
That's a tough one.
Really tough. That's a tough one to swallow
and
right there.
He's moving on the ground while he's got it.
Yeah. Now, there's only 3 seconds on the shot clock, so they're going to get it back. So, number one, you cannot foul.
Yeah, that's the big one.
Keep the ball in front, cannot foul, and you got to rebound.
83-81, a close one just as we suspected. Both these teams putting up quite the fight. And now they're going to review it, it looks like. I'm looking at the referees right now, and it's Chuck Jones at the replay monitor. And you have to wonder, what are they even...
Well, are they allowed the timeout,
yeah.
So I'm not really sure how they can reverse this.
I mean, yeah, it's not like you could take back the timeout and keep going from there. They might be checking on how much is on the shot clock.
Yeah, very true.
And I didn't see any changes to the clock. Still 2:11, still 3 on the shot clock, and that's where it'll stay.
So again, if you're Portland, you cannot foul. You got to keep the ball in front, switch everything here, and you've got a rebound.
So San Diego with 3 seconds. Townsend's got to be quick with it. Robertson keeping his hands up. Townsend short on that shot, and a rebound by Robertson.
Good defense.
That's exactly what they needed right there. Robertson, 19 points, 7 assists, and 5 rebounds. So we close in. We're under 2 minutes left in this one. A 2-point lead for Portland.
San Diego staying in the zone.
Robertson had an opening momentarily. And that pass goes out of bounds, and it'll be San Diego basketball. And what I like to see out of this is you're not seeing the normal flair you usually see out of Shante, but you've got Robertson and Nduka talking to the young freshman right there about what he should change and do differently in that situation.
Well, you know, it's a learning moment, obviously. Uh-huh. Hopefully you don't learn too much at the 1.5-minute mark, but, I mean, you need him in the game, so got to keep the confidence.
San Diego hasn't made a shot in nearly 3 minutes. Applewhite almost got it away from Erlington, and it's off the chest of Williams Jr. A turnover for San Diego, their 8th one in this game, 6th in this half.
Well, and Gorizito actually kind of caused a little bit of that, coming from behind, real handsy, obviously making him go a little bit too quick. San Diego turns it over with a minute 23.
Here's another look at it.
Applewhite.
Yep. I mean, Applewhite did a good job of stepping up in front of Erlington. That caused all of that mishap to happen because Erlington thought he had an opening right there.
Yep. Again, he's come in on both ends of the floor and made a difference tonight, and that's exactly what you need. You know, it's not about starting necessarily. You got to know your role, and right now with injuries, people coming in and out, people getting healthy, he's going to be productive in either a starting position or coming off the bench, and he's been terrific tonight.
Yeah, he's been a +8 on the floor. 9 points, 4 rebounds, 4 assists, and 2 steals. Applewhite is having himself a day.
Well, the little things matter. I mean, each possession, you know, free throw misses, all that's going to come down here at the wire.
And San Diego keeping the pressure off. It looks like they're in a zone again.
Yep, staying in that zone.
Inside to Robertson. Spins inside, found the corner man in Wood, and he's got the three!
Great execution by the Pilots against the zone. Robertson just doing a nice job of maintaining the defense in the middle and finds Wood on the corner.
Jawara using the glass after a minor hip check from Robertson. Portland has gotten hot right when they needed it. They've hit their last 7 shots from the field, and it's led to a 3-point lead.
One possession game with about 18 seconds different in the shot clock. Got to have a great offensive possession if you are the Pilots.
Looked like they wanted to go ISO for a second. Now they give it to Gorosito. He's alone on the far side. Pulls up three from the wheel. Almost had it. Offensive rebound, Robertson. No foul called. Erlington. And they got a charge. It's the freshman Gorosito stepping up.
Well, the mistake that he made a minute ago just picked up right there by getting the charge call, doing a good job of sliding over and taking the contact.
Could have had his feet moving just a tad there, but the freshman standing his ground takes the charge. And Coach Lavin, he's not happy with that last call. You could see why. There was a bit of movement in the feet of Gorosito, but it works out for the Pilots. 15.9 seconds left. There's no shot clock, so you have to be guessing that San Diego's going to be fouling.
Yeah, you have to in this situation. Number one, go for a steal. Put the pressure on. They're going to go for the steal. They can run the baseline here, I believe. No, they're going to be stuck, I think.
86-83.
You got to foul immediately if you do not get a steal here. Extend this game.
Each team has one timeout remaining as well. And both teams are in the bonus. Oh, correction, San Diego just used their last timeout. So Portland is the only one with a timeout. And it's 1-1 for both sides. And so you hate to say it. Robertson's been a little cold for Portland. San Diego, do you even attempt to try to do that?
I'd still, if I'm Coach Legs, I'd have him at the line.
Okay.
He's a gamer.
Yeah, absolutely.
When it matters, he will come through.
San Diego, kind of on their last breath right now. They're going to have to make a couple of plays late in this one, and you see how the freshman has done tonight. 11 points and a rebound and a very, very big charge taken just before that break.
Well, you got four guys that are really good from the free throw line for Portland.
And Duca trying to inbound it. And it's still Portland basketball.
They're going to review it.
Yeah, they are going to review it just to make sure. And that was a tight play right there. It looked like Williams Jr. was on defense of Robertson.
I mean, from my vantage point, I couldn't see.
Yeah, it was too bang, bang.
This is a big call, though. I mean, they get the ball back with 15 and a half to go.
I mean, that's one where you don't necessarily have to shoot a three right away. If you get a quick bucket, you can still foul. And here, you'll get a look at this replay right here.
Ooh, I don't know.
You can see how they would think that Sissoho Juwara was the last one to touch it. But wow, that is very close. And it looks like they might already be done looking at it.
Taking a look at it.
And it'll stay with Portland, they say. Here's another look.
Oh, yeah, that's a good call.
Yeah.
Good job. Good job by the officiating crew right there. Just Robertson got himself really tight on that baseline.
All right.
Portland's got one timeout left.
Yeah, they still have their timeout. Got to make a move. And Aduka has to burn the timeout for Portland. And now Portland is stuck because San Diego, you don't want to say stuck, excuse me, but they're in a tough spot. With San Diego playing tough defense those last two inbounds, no more timeouts for Portland. You have to get it in. And with how San Diego's been playing defense lately, could cause some trouble.
Yeah, last two times trying to get the ball inbounds, they're just trying to go one-on-one and pop open. They got to go set a screen or do something, spread the floor a little bit more so there's a little bit more opportunity for space to get the ball in. You know, you don't want them handing the ball off there at that baseline. I think they're going to make a substitution here.
And who do you think they bring in for this?
I think they put Jack in, Jack Perry in.
And that's one of the most sure-handed guys you can have on the court if you're Portland. Hasn't played a lot of minutes tonight.
I have a feeling he might be the one inbounding the basketball.
Yeah, exactly.
The other thing is you don't want to turn the ball over deep here. You want to go in the backcourt, or in the front court, excuse me. If you're going to throw it long.
And you're right. So it's Jack Perry now in the game for Chica and Duca. Perry's only played it 2 minutes so far in this game.
Well, this is a big inbound right here.
15 and a half seconds left. 3-point ball game. Perry trying to get the inbound to Robertson. It's poked away, it looked like, by McKinley III.
Well, better job. They actually had Moses Wood wide open.
And now Sholin is going to check in. Okay, so Gorosito goes to the bench. And Sholin's just going to hang back now, try to get a defender on the other side of the court. And Jawara will get called for the foul. And good for San Diego, because that's quick. Not much time came off. I think maybe 0.5 seconds.
Well, they made it really hard for them to get the ball in. I mean, they inbound four times there in a row just to get the one foul with 1 second off the clock. That's a really good job defensively.
I would count that as a win for San Diego on
Absolutely.
That possession.
Now, if you're Portland, you got to do the job at the free throw line. Yeah. Knocking down the 1-on-1 here.
Wood is 4-for-4 tonight. He's got 24 points, 8-of-9 shooting from the field. Calm, cool, and collected. Makes that one. He's got 25 points, the redshirt junior from Reno, Nevada. Had 19 points against Gonzaga last Saturday. And he goes 2-for-2. This time around, 26 points and a bit of cushion now for Portland. They're up by five.
Little come behind.
Irwington gets a pass stolen away by Robertson. And that'll do it. 88-83. Pilots come away with a victory on their home court, and man, was it needed for these guys going forward.
That's a big win. They needed that, like you said, and a really hard-fought game, back and forth. Teams really scoring the ball at times, and then I thought Portland's defense in the second half made some good adjustments, and then obviously being able to score the ball the way they can, and that's a good home win right there.
I mean, you look at the score, 88-83. San Diego made 30 baskets, Portland made 31, but San Diego had more opportunities. They had 14 more shots to possibly get a couple more baskets, and they just were unable to do so. The tough defense from the Pilots, especially down the stretch, not giving up any easy baskets, and it helps the Pilots get to a 5-point victory.
Well, and they had a nice night offensively. They shared the ball really well and shot at a high clip. I mean, if you're shooting at a high clip, you don't need the possessions necessarily, but I thought they made some really good stops when they needed to. We saw growth by different people. Gorosito, I think, did a nice job coming in, obviously getting the start, had a good night shooting the basketball, learned some things defensively, but also made some good plays for him defensively.
So it's a good night to be a Pilot as they end up in the handshake line. Moses Wood with 26 points, 8-of-9 from the field, 4-of-5 from behind the arc, 6-for-6 from the free throw line with 7 rebounds and an assist. He had a heck of a day for the Pilots. And you talk about a key member that has been off the court a little bit as of late and now coming back. I mean, huge scoring output right there for 26 points. Every point really needed in this one.
Yeah, and 18 in the second half. And he has the ability to score in all areas of the game. I mean, he can score down low. He can mid-range game. And his three-point ability to shoot the ball coming off screens, just terrific. When he gets his feet set and he's in rhythm, he's hard to stop. And 26 points, like I said, 18 in that second half. The Pilots really needed him to step up and be a part of it.
As Moses is getting ready and set up for us, he's the man we're going to be talking to as Tyler Robertson just came by and gave us a little fist bump after the win. 88-83 is the victory for the Pilots today. And now we've got Moses Wood joining us. Moses, you have 26 points in this one, 8 in the first half, 18 in the second half. What really opened up for you in these final 20 minutes?
I think my team just did a great job finding me. You know, my teammates made plays for me, and that's what allowed me to get those 18 in the second half. So Yeah.
What was the message at halftime? Obviously a very close game. Adjustments that you guys made coming into this second half and pulling out the victory.
Yeah, the big emphasis for us at halftime was just getting stops. They were just making really tough shots, and, you know, we knew we had to get into them and, you know, make them start missing. And, you know, our offense was going to come. We knew that would keep going. So.
Hey, you guys had a different starting lineup today with Anduka and Gorosito getting the start. How impressive has the young man Gorosito been for you guys? A freshman really stepping up and getting into this rotation.
He's been huge. I mean, like the shots he hits are so big time, you know, for a freshman. Like, that's huge. He's been a huge help to us, and he works really hard, so he deserves that.
All right. Hey, Moses, fantastic game. 26 points. Hit the ice bath. Rest up a little bit. Great game tonight, and best of luck the rest of the way.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
All right. That was Moses Wood joining us post game. 26 points. And 18 of them coming in the second half. And he really put on a show for the faithful here inside the Child Center.
Joined the 1,000-point club.
Yes, he did. Part of the 1,000-point club now. That's Jennifer Mountain. Thank you to the production crew all around inside the Child Center. We can never do it without you guys. I'm Brian Slyke. Thank you for joining us on our broadcast on the WCC Network.